Hey guys, welcome to Coding Simplified, and today we'll see that how we can use the stack into parsing the arithmetic expression. So basically we have given an arithmetic expression, so first we convert that into the postfix, so that we call them the infix. So infix to postfix. So why we do postfix? Because these arithmetic operations are solved in the postfix to evaluation manner, right? So once you have the postfix, then it easily solve, right? So that is how we use the postfix, and that is why there is need to convert from infix to postfix, right? So here we can assume that you know the basic rules of converting from infix to postfix, but still we'll explain you and we'll do the code in Java. So let me show you. First of all, what I'm doing here, I have the strings which are explained as the arithmetic expression. So like here I have the s1 string, then here I have the s2 string, and here I have the s3 string. So now by simply you can say that how this will operate. First this will calculate 2 plus 3, 5, then minus 1, 4, right? So our answer would be 4 in the arithmetic expression. Now what is the case here? So here we can see that first it will solve this one, 3 into 4, 12, and then it will add this 2, right? So answer would be 14. And what would be here in this case? So in this case what would happen, that first of all it will solve whatever in the brackets. So like in this case, first of all it will solve 4 plus 5, which is 9, then it will solve 9 into 3, 27. Similarly here it will solve first 1 plus 2, which is 3, and then 6 upon 3, which is 2. So it will say final 27 minus 2 is 25, right? So that is how it solves the problem. So here we know that how it operates. So the same conditions we need to apply in our code, right? Those are the same rules we need to apply in our code. So let me show you the basic rules. First of all, what we are saying, that we'll use it through stack. So here I have used the stack Java library. You can also implement stack by your own. So we have explained how we can implement stack using array or using linked list. So you can see these videos in our playlist. So here we have using the Java library of stack. So now I am saying here that my all the stack element will be the characters. Now here I am creating a new string postfix, which will be my final string. So I'm initializing it as null string. Now I'm converting all the string which I am passing all the expression into character array. Now I'm saying that if the character is a number or is apart than the operators. So we are using these operators in our expression, plus, minus, multiplication, division, and open parenthesis and close parenthesis. You can use any operators you want as per your expression, but here our focus is mainly on these operators, plus, minus, multiplication, division, and open and close parenthesis, right? So we are saying that if our character is apart than these characters, then you need to add into postfix. That would be added into my answer, right? So I'm increasing postfix equal to postfix plus character. Now if the character is open parenthesis, then you need to simply put into stack, because what we are saying basically, that if there is any operator, so we need to put into stack. But if it is just a number, then put in the answer in your resultant list, right? So what would happen, because stack would contain all the operators, so as per the rules we'll pop out the elements and we'll keep on adding into resultant list. So here we'll explain you one by one. So here we are saying that if it is open parenthesis, so put into stack. Now if it is a closed parenthesis, so if it is a closed parenthesis, so we can assume that there would have been the open parenthesis also. So check that if stack is not empty, so operate this loop until stack is not empty and pop out the one element, and check that if it is not the open parenthesis, then add into the resultant list, right? Because there may be two or three operators in between. So we are saying that whatever the operator is, even if there is one operator, so put them into the resultant list and do this until stack is not empty, right? And whenever we find that we have the open parenthesis, then break, right? So like it would be helpful in this case, because like here what would happen that one, when we'll put this one, so this is in stack, so when it will encounter this one and when we'll pop out the element, then there will be this one. So we'll say there is a 1 plus, it means add into the resultant list, and when it will encounter open parenthesis, so we'll loop out, right? So we'll break from the loop. So we have covered this one, open parenthesis and close parenthesis. Now we would check that if our character is among these operators, plus, minus, multiplication and division. In this case, if stack is empty, so just push this into stack. Now if stack is not empty, it means there is already these operators into stack. So what we need to do, first we'll pop the element which is at the top. Now we'll check that if at the top is a open bracket, it means open parenthesis, it means we need not to add anything. We will again push this element whatever we have popped out, and we'll break the loop. Now if it is not the case, it means these operators are among the popped one. Now we check this by the priority. So what is the rule? We say that if the priority of the current element is the higher than the priority of what is at the stack, so we need to push the element again what we have popped out, and then at the last we'll push the same element which is right now the current element. So let's say if it in the stack it was the plus, right, and the whatever we are putting into now is the multiplication. So the multiplication priority is 2 and the plus priority is 1. It means we'll push both these element, we'll again push the plus, and then at the last we'll push the multiplication, right? So we get the priority from, so we have made a function that if c equals to plus or minus, then return minus, return 1, else return the 2, right? So that is how we'll get the priority. So that's what we are doing here, that if you have the higher priority element which you are calculating now, then push both of them into stack. If it is the opposite case, if the priority of the elements are the same or lower, then you need to push into the resultant list whatever we are popping out, right? So t is the element which we have popped out from the stack, so put this into resultant list, right, and later push the element into stack what we are currently doing. Now at the last, check that whatever you have left into stack and put that into the resultant list which is your postfix list, right, and at the last return the postfix. Now let me show you that with the simple examples how we are doing this. So like this is a case 2 plus 3 minus 1. So what should be our answer? If we say in the layman language, our answer should be that first we'll calculate the 2 plus 3 and then we'll do minus 1, right? So how, what should be the postfix operation? First is the operator, so first is the operand, so we'll say 2. Now plus is the operator, so we'll put them into stack. Now 3 is again the operand, so we'll put them into the resultant list. Now is the minus 1. So because minus 1 will going to go here and plus is already in the stack, so when we'll pop out the element from the stack, the top element which is plus, so it will say plus and minus priority are same. It means we can put plus into the resultant list and then we can put the minus into our stack. Then 1 would come, so 1 would be added into the list, into the string, into the final string, and then we are done. So now we'll check whatever the left into stack, so minus is left, so now add minus into the final string, right? So it will go here, it will initialize the stack, it will initialize the postfix as a null string, then it will transfer all these into character array. Now our first character is 2, so it will add into the final list which is postfix. Our next is plus, so plus would be added, it will go here, and because our stack is empty, so it will push into the stack 1. Now our operator is 3, so again it would add into the final list final string. Now it is minus, right? So it is minus, so it will go here and it will check that stack is not empty. It would go here, and here it will check that it, first of all, it will pop the element. So popping of the element is plus. So now it will go ahead plus, and the priority is 1, and again it will send the priority is 1 of the minus 1. So it will say the priority are same, so it means put the resultant, put the T which we had popped out into the final string. So here we have done, and now we'll put the minus 1 into the stack. So now what is the left one? So our character is 1, so it will add into the final string. So at the last we are done, and whatever into stack pop out and add into the final string, and at the last return. So if you see here that what is the final output, is 2, 3 plus 1 minus, right? So if we calculate using postfix evaluation, what would happen? That it will first solve 2 plus 3, and then 2 plus 3 is 5, then it would solve 5 1 minus, which is 5 minus 1 6, sorry 4, right? So that is how it would solve. Now we are doing this one. So what should happen in this one? First it will put 2 into final string, then plus would go into stack, then 3 would add into final string, and then multiplication will come. So now it would check that the multiplication priority is the higher than the plus 1. So add the plus, so keep push the plus also and add the multiplication also into stack. Now 4 would add into string. So we are done in full string. Now whatever the left into the stack, pop out and keep on adding the element. So first multiplication will be added. So then plus will be added into stack, into the list. So again, let me show you how we are doing. So first 2 will come, so 2 will be added into the string. Then plus would come, so plus, because the stack is empty, so it would be added into the list. Now 3 would come, so 3 would be added into the string. Now multiplication will come, so stack is not empty, it would go here. First will pop out the element, pop out the element is a plus 1. Now it would check that what is T, T is the plus. So what is the priority? So priority of multiplication is greater than the plus. So first push again this element. So we'll push the plus into stack, then we'll break, and at the last we'll push the multiplication also. So means both the plus and multiplication are into stack. Then we have the 1 which will add into postfix list. Now at the last we'll keep on popping out the element and one by one add into the postfix list. And at the last you can see our output is 2, 3, 4 multiplication then plus, right? Now we'll do this one. So what should happen into this one? That first 3 would be added into the final string, then multiplication would go into the stack. Now again this opening parenthesis will again go into the stack. Now 4 would go into the final string and plus. So when plus would go into the here, so it would check that what is the opening, what is the first to pop out the element. So when you would pop out the element, this open parenthesis would come, right? So you would say, if it is the case, so again put into the stack and put also this one. Now 5 would go into the final string, and then close parenthesis would come. So close parenthesis, when it will go in, when it will go, first of all, it will pop out the element. What is the element? So it would say this is the case. It means first you put into the resultant list, right? Because this is not the case. Now again you will pop out. So you, in popping out, you will get this one. So if it is a case, so you don't do anything, you don't push this one, and obviously you won't push also this one, right? Now what would happen? You would add the minus 1 into the stack. Now 6 would go into the final string, then it would come division. So division priority is greater than the minus 1, so both minus and the division would be into stack. Now it would come the open parenthesis. So because this is open parenthesis, we don't do anything, we just push into stack. Now 1 would come, and 1 will go into the string, and plus will go into the stack because we have this open parenthesis into stack. Now close parenthesis would come. So first of all, it will pop out this element, this plus, and it would add into the string. Because this is a close parenthesis, in the next popping out element, so we won't do anything, and at the last, whatever the remaining is, so remaining is the division one first and then the minus one. So one by one they would add into the list. So let me show you it. And here, first of all, it will change. Now it would have the character. So first of all, it is 3, so it would add. Now it has the multiplication, so it would add it because the stack is empty, so it would go into the stack. Now our character is parenthesis, open parenthesis, so it would just go into stack.push. Now our next is plus, sorry, 4, so it would go into the string. Now next character is plus, so it is a plus, so it will go here, and stack is not empty, so first of all it will popping out the element. What is the element? It is open parenthesis. So if it is the open parenthesis, so put open parenthesis again into the stack, and at the last push the plus into the stack. Now it would check, it is 5, so it would go into the string. Now it is the close. So when it has the close parenthesis, we'll go here, we'll check that until stack is not empty, check the character. So the character is plus, so it means add into the string. Now again pop out the element. So now our element is open parenthesis. So if it is open parenthesis, it means break out the from the loop, right? We won't add this into stack. Now again check what is the character is minus. So it would go here and it would put minus 1. So t is the multiplication and our c is minus. So we'll say the priority of the minus is less than the multiplication, so it would go in this one and it would add the multiplication into the postfix list, and at the last we'll add the minus 1 into stack. Again it will go, and what is the character here? Right now the character is 6, so it would go in the resultant list. Now again, what is the character? The character is division. So it would go here and it will check that division's priority is greater than the minus 1. So it would go and it will push the minus again, and at the last it will push the division also. Now what is the character? Our character is the opening parenthesis, so again it will push into stack. Now our next one is 1, so it would be added into the string. Now our next one is the close one, sorry, plus, so again it is a plus, so it will go here, it would check what is the first popping out the element, so it was this one, so again we'll push the opening one, and at the last we'll push the plus one. Now again it will go, now we have the 2, we'll add into string, and at the last we have the close parenthesis. So when we have the close parenthesis, we'll first pop out the element. Popping out the element is plus 1, so we'll add into the string. And now what is the popping out the element? So this was the closed one. So if it is a closed one, we won't do anything. Now we have done with the every character. So whatever left in the stack, pop out and add into the final string. So if you see that our final resultant list is 3, 4, 5 plus, then multiplication, then 6, 1, 2 plus division and minus, right? So when this will go in the evolution, first it will operate this one for 4, 5 plus, then at the last it will solve whatever the answer is this one, then this one, and at the last till last operator, right? So in our next tutorial we'll solve that how we can calculate the postfix to evaluation. But for this tutorial we have explained from only infix to postfix. So guys, we have covered that how we can do infix to postfix operation using the stack. And if you have any doubts, please write in the comment section. I know this is a little bit big problem. So that's it for this video. And if you have liked the video, please like it and subscribe the channel for more such videos. Thank you.